This movie doesn't make sense. Who would want to kill David Hasselhoff? Killing Hasselhoff is 2017 comedy movie that stars, of course, David Hasselhoff, then also Gin Yoong from Hangover. Jim Jefferies, the comedian. I have seen some clips of him doing stand-up and he's hilarious. Ken's character is he owns a nightclub and he's in debt for $400,000. And he and his friends have this celebrity death pool. Not Deadpool, but Deathpool. And every year he bets that David Hasselhoff will die next that year. If David Hasselhoff would die, he would get $500,000, so he could pay off the debt. And the loan shark, when he learns about Deathpool, he tries to kill David Hasselhoff also. Ken has a friend that goes crazy during the movie. And at first he was decent character, nothing special, but not annoying, but when he goes crazy, yeah, he's somewhat annoying. David Hasselhoff has a manager, and Hasselhoff wants to make a superhero musical, because of course he can sing somewhat, and he thinks he can play a superhero. And that's pretty much what David Hasselhoff does in this movie. He talks about the musical and then he drives the Knight Rider car, Kit. And then he saves Michael Winslow from drowning, Baywatch style. I didn't saw a trailer for this movie, but I knew that he's gonna be this self-centered, narcissistic person who loves himself, and of course he was that type of character. I don't know if it was David Hasselhoff or somebody else that I have seen in very similar role. It might have been David Hasselhoff in some other movie or TV show or whatever, and it's kind of sad to see him like that. I know that he's not the greatest actor in the world, but I would like to see him in a serious movie, in a serious role. So overall, I think this was a decent comedy, nothing spectacular. I have seen maybe one or two very similar movies, but it did have David Hasselhoff and few good cameos, and Jim Jefferies was in this movie also. And if you have ever wanted to see his naked ass, you can see that in this movie. And as a heterosexual man, I would like to also point out that we get to see a very nice pair of tits. Just to balance it all out. And since in my new title card there are 5 stars, so I guess I have to grade movies by stars now. So I give this movie 3 out of 5 stars. Nothing special. If you saw 2017 Baywatch and didn't like it, this is not a movie for you, probably. But I liked Baywatch and I liked this one as well. Anyway, thanks for watching.